Good day, viewer. My name's Don. Thanks for joining George and Pat Pugh on a tour of Rottnest Island, 2006. We pay the $50 ferry fee and catch the Rottnest ferry from Roust Head. There's a rush on arrival, and the kids are off and racing. Rottnest Island is a glorious holiday destination. It has a long maritime history, the home of many a shipwreck. Many sailors have died hitting the coral reefs of this island. We are in Thompson Bay and grab a bite to eat before our departure for a 20-kilometer trip around the island. We are not alone, even young children ride bicycles. Although we are 20 kilometers from Perth, we can clearly see the skyline. Rottnest has a somber history, being an Aboriginal prison during the 19th century. Many of its buildings were built by Aboriginal convict labor and date from that time. This early chapel is an example. George Amire's Rottnest Lodge, a favorite holiday accommodation. Let's get going. George recalls landing a small plane on the Rottnest runway back in 1978. One can learn a lot about flora and fauna by reading the many signs dotted over the island. There's Rebecca and Mark at Parker's Point, 6.5 kilometers. On the road. Trees are twisted and bent from the prevailing winds. Coral reefs anger the sea and attract seabirds. George stops and takes notes from many of the small signs. We reach Little Salmon Bay, a popular swimming area. It's time to move on towards the lighthouse. There's a great view from the lighthouse. Where's all the quokkas? Pat asks. Quokkas are a small marsupial, and we soon find them. They're very friendly and lick your fingers. It's back to Thompson Bay to catch the ferry. Mark's wheelchair battery has gone dead, and he's not moving very quickly. We stop for refreshments. Thanks, viewer, for joining George and Pat, Mark and Rebecca and myself for this trip to Rottnest Island, Western Australia. Have a good day.